Could SpaceX and Tesla founder Elon Musk become a real-life Zefram Cochrane, the fictional inventor of warp drive on Star Trek? Astrophysicist and science personality Neil deGrasse Tyson seems to think so. Faster than light FTL travel is a staple of sci-fi, hand-waving away multi-millennia journeys between stars. Such a technology would of course be incredibly handy to use in the real world, and while these warp drives have been considered theoretically possible, they usually involve exotic physics that are out of our reach. Want to know about it? Well, stay tuned to the video and watch the video till the end. Hello guys, welcome to the Elon Musk exclusive. Hit the subscribe button and turn on the notifications to get new updates about technology and development and basically anything around real Tony Stark, Elon Musk. Hit the like button to show your support, and in today's video, we're going to talk about Elon Musk finally reveals new warp drive Starship 2022, so without any further ado, let's begin. Mexican theoretical physicist Miguel Alcubierre presented that space-time compression at the front of a spaceship while stretching it from behind, provided it was actually mathematically possible using the laws of general relativity. To better understand the term warp drive, some may be familiar with the 1960 sci-fi show Star Trek, where the crew needed to go somewhere fast. Captain Kirk gave his famous command, Mr. Sulu, execute. The ship was pushed swiftly to another distant destination. Physics has scoffed at the idea of a real warp drive because it suggests travel faster than light. However, as the drive's name suggests, such an engine did not push the spacecraft faster than the speed of light. Instead, it merely warped space-time in a way that allowed for using a shortcut. But the new study has a workaround. According to researchers from the independent research group Applied Physics based in New York, it's possible to ditch the fiction of negative energy and still make a warp drive, albeit one that is slower than in Star Trek, Science Alert reports. To put it simply, this method of space travel involves stretching the fabric of spacetime in a wave which would, in theory, cause the space ahead of an object to contract while the space behind it would expand. An object inside this wave, that is, a spaceship, would be then able to ride this region known as a warp bubble of flat space. This is what is known as the Alcubierre Metric. Interpreted in the context of general relativity, the metric allows a warp bubble to appear in a previously flat region of spacetime and move away, effectively at speeds that exceed the speed of a light. The interior of the bubble is the inertial reference frame for any object inhabiting it. Since the ship is not moving within this bubble, but is being carried along as the region itself moves, conventional relativistic effects such as time dilation would not apply. Hence, the rules of spacetime and the laws of relativity would not be violated in the conventional sense. One of the reasons for this is that this method would not rely on moving faster than light in the local sense, since a light beam within this bubble would still always move faster than the ship. It's only faster than light in the sense that the ship could reach its destination faster than a beam of light that was traveling outside the warp bubble. SpaceX aims to develop such systems, of course, and has made a great deal of progress so far. The first stages of the California-based company's Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets are reusable, and SpaceX has successfully landed 49 boosters during orbital missions to date. Many of these rockets have flown again, often several times. The SpaceX routinely reflies its robotic Dragon cargo capsules on resupply missions to the International Space Station for NASA. But SpaceX is aiming higher. Its Starship Mars colonizing transportation system is designed to be fully reusable. That system consists of a big spaceship called Starship and a huge rocket known as Super Heavy, both of which are still in development. Indeed, Musk wants each Starship component eventually to fly many times and on a fast turnaround. The billionaire entrepreneur has said he envisions 1,000 Starships heading off to Mars every 26 months when Earth and the Red Planet align favorably for interplanetary flight. This is the sort of radical innovation that would keep the United States on top in space, Musk said. And such tech could put the country on the path towards something even more ambitious, he added, a truly sci-fi future. We gotta make Starfleet happen, Musk said, referring to the United Federation of Planets Space Force in the Star Trek universe. When the public hears Space Force, that's when they think, it's like, okay, we're gonna have some sweet spaceships and pretty good uniforms and stuff. There are many who think that NASA is building a warp drive. The idea that NASA is secretly working on a warp drive technology has been around for a long time. In fact, in the mid-2000s, NASA brought in scientist Dr. Harold G. Sonny White to continue developing the warp drive. White made refinements to the original model, and in 2003 and 2011, significant leaps were made in warp drive theory. However, he left NASA in 2019 to work at a Houston-based nonprofit called the Limitless Space Institute. Nevertheless, he continued working on this project with NASA's approval. Fast forward to the present, White and his team at Limitless Space Institute have accidentally created the first warp bubble. However, according to White, the finding is not a warp bubble analog, it's a real, albeit humble and tiny warp bubble, meaning the manifested bubble is incredibly small to move an actual spacecraft, but the implications of this discovery are huge. Anyway, this is a breakthrough, and a full-size warp-capable spacecraft is now within our reach. The recent development brought a new wave of interest in the idea of a warp drive. We can assume that NASA is doing or going to do some secret work in the area of faster-than-light travel. Interstellar travel has been hampered by the long time it takes to reach other stars. It would take 17,000 to 76,000 years to reach our nearest star, Proxima Centauri, with our current technology. Meanwhile, warp travel would take us to the nearest star in less than 4 years, White said. As the universe is unimaginably big, researchers tend to use light years to describe the distance between objects. In short, a light year is the distance light travels in one Earth year. Light is the fastest thing in our universe, traveling at a speed of approximately 186,000 miles or 300,000 kilometers per second. One light year is approximately 6 trillion miles or 9 trillion kilometers. If you want to travel to something a little closer like the sun, it would take 8.3 minutes to reach your destination traveling at the speed of light. However, if you wanted to go to our closest big galaxy, Andromeda, it would take you 2.5 million light years. Even if humans were able to create a ship that could travel at the speed of light, our potential destinations would still be limited. Much easier, but still annoying. As we said, the universe is unimaginably large. However, could we create a ship that travels faster than light? Though this sounds like something out of your favorite science fiction show or movie, a warp drive may not be as unrealistic as once thought. In fact, it may be crucial to our survival. I don't think the human race will survive the next 1,000 years unless we spread into space. There are too many accidents that can befall life on a single planet, but I'm an optimist. We will reach out to the stars, said the late Stephen Hawking. While a warp drive that uses conventional energy sources could be a major breakthrough, the new Solidton method has its own hurdles, of course. It would still require an absolutely enormous amount of energy that just isn't feasible right now, but there may be hope yet. The energy savings would need to be drastic, of approximately 30 orders of magnitude, to be in the range of modern nuclear fission reactors, says Lenz. Fortunately, several energy-saving mechanisms have been proposed in earlier research that can potentially lower the energy required by nearly 60 orders of magnitude. Neil deGrasse Tyson tweeted Musk a brief letter asking when the entrepreneur was going to quit messing around with Mars rockets, Hyperloop, Cybertrucks, and brain-computer interfaces and instead focus his resources on developing a warp drive like we see powering the spaceships across galaxies in Star Trek. If we create a city on Mars, Earth-Mars travel will be a powerful forcing function for inventing something like warp drive. Tyson's request was all in good fun. This little Twitter back and forth isn't likely to change Musk's trajectory or get us any closer to a real warp drive. Warp drive and teleportation? Probably not, Musk said. But big spaceships that can go far places? Definitely, that can be done. Now that we've come to the end of this video, I want to thank you for sticking with me, and I'd love to know what you think of it. Just comment down below. Also, if you like this video, make sure you like it and stay safe. Today's video is over, but if you want to see more, there's one on your screen right now. And there are a few more fun videos coming soon about everyday technology. I'll see you in the next video.